Hello, my friends of Atari Labs. My name is Saul Montoya. Please welcome to this tutorial. This tutorial is for a geospatial Python class for crop recognition. So what is the purpose of this tutorial? I have done those some tutorials on the same topic that were related about to recognize plants from a drone imagery. Okay, so this is a drone orthophoto where we have identified some points. For example, here we have some points. Here, okay, we have here identify some points. Maybe you want it. Okay, so these are the points that we have identified. Okay, in this case, we have only 3 points identified because this is a time and resources consuming process. I mean, if we want to develop a tutorial that will be of 10 minutes, we are going to work with just 3 plants. I mean, but and I think that for a normal workflow that you should work with 50 plants, and then you should work with something like 1 hour and a half. I mean, the process can take 1 hour and a half. Okay, so here we have the raster, and then you are going to use this shape file, and that's it. So this is the two spatial data inputs that we are going to use. So let's work with Anaconda. So CD documents, okay, and then here you are going to I'm going to upload a Git repository. So if you in order to conda you have to install Git, conda install Git, yeah, in order to do that. Okay, because it's the orthophoto is really heavy to be stored on the website. And then what we are going to do is cd crop, no, cd Python here, cd special Python class for crop recognition, then here JupyterLab. JupyterLab, great. Okay. Okay. And I will explain what I have done. I have done a Python class. The Python class is here in working tools, so this is what I have coded. It's not that much, okay, but they do a lot. So we import the Python class, okay, and then we create a crop object. Okay, then we have to when then we define the raster, and then we define the points. Okay, but for this, oops, sorry, this is agave crop. This is just like this. Oh, sorry. Sorry, because I have updated this. This is agave crop. Okay. So, for this is really important that both, I mean, the points and the raster will has to be in the same system of reference. Okay. So, and then we define the points. Then we can retrieve some information because this is related to the class, so we can retrieve the system of reference, and then we can retrieve the coordinates of the points. Okay, this is in WES84. Then we define some radius. I mean, the radius is from the point which will be the radius of analysis. I mean, if the plant has a radius of 6 pixels, will be 6. If the plant has a radius of 10, 20, and so on, so this is the point radius, and this is the analysis is not done over the is not done over the over all the bands. You have to specify which band are you are going to use. So in this case will be the blue band, and then you will sample the row and column of the points and the array. Okay, so we can sample the array. You will see what this means, the array. So this is the blue band. Yeah, well with an specified color map for the tree plants that you have selected, or the tree plants that are on the corresponding to the to each of these. For example, this one on the blue band and with this color map will be, let me check which one will be. Sorry. The problem is that the same color that is when is, yeah, it will be number 3. So this will be this one. Okay. Great. So we can perform a single template. I mean, we can perform just the template of this, and then we can export this as a raster file. We are not going to do that, or we can do that. I mean, match template 2, because this is 0, 1, 2, and this is 2, and this match will be match template 2. Okay, so with that, we do one match template, and with that as well, you will get this. Okay. So here on raster, you will have, let me, maybe it's still working. Let me check. Yeah, it's still working. And it will create a raster file. The result of this is a completely georeferenced raster file. Okay, I will do a pause till it's done. Okay, it's done. Maybe it took 2 minutes. So here I have the match template 2. And this is how a match template actually looks like. Okay, this is what is the match template where, and the code, what it does is do a filter on this, okay, in order to select the points that has a higher match. I mean, for example, here for this plant, so for this plant we have a value of 1 here. However, here we will have values of 0.1, 0.2, and for example here we have a higher value. So that's why we do a filter on this, in order just to identify, because the value that will have a higher match template will be the values that are identify another plant. Okay, great. So okay, so this is how a single match is. Okay, sorry, this is a single match template, and this is a row. This is not, this is more now. This is a match for all points. So we define the threshold. You can define it in between threshold or quantile. In the case of quantile, the values are higher than 0.9996. I mean, the values that provide me kind of a good quality of crop recognition. Here in this case, I'm going to work with 0.32. Okay. You can work with 0.40. I mean, as long as this value will be lower, you will have more points. However, you will have some features that are not necessary plants that are identified as plants. As long as this value is higher, you will have a better accuracy. However, you will have less plants identified. Okay, so in this case, 0.32, let's work with that. Okay, so it's processing for image 0, 1, and 2. I'm going to make a pause here. Okay, great. So we have processed this for the 3 points. Okay, well, it's image because every point defines a plant image. Okay, so we can plot all templates. However, we can plot that here. However, we are not going to do that. We can save our matches to a shape files, to a point shape file. And then, well, while we do the cluster analysis, okay, so we are going to do the birch clustering. Oh, in this case is I'm doing shift enter to run the cells, by the way. So we can plot the birch points and then we can save it as a shape file. So let's see. Okay. Here what the this is the match crop. I mean these are the point identification, for example this, for example this. Okay. And here you have for some points, okay. And then comes the how say the spoiler, no, how say the complainers, okay? I mean what we find is a right match. I mean there is a right match, okay? And then I will plot the birch. I mean what will be the birch? The birch is the cluster analysis. For example, these 4 points on the birch will be defined as just one, okay? Because actually we don't have four plants there, we only have one. Okay, great. Okay, so what is the problem? I mean that we have defined just some crops here, okay? And then you see that you will have more crops, and this is why, because in this case, what we are developing right now is just a tutorial that works just with three crops. And as I told you, a normal workflow will be to work with 50 plants, okay? So you can create a shape file of 50 plants, and then the processing will be much, much longer, okay? And then even you can increase the threshold. However, you can do that because, like, this is only tutorial. I mean, this is not your research. Well, we hope that this tutorial was to show you the Python class, that I made it very intuitive, that I made it very clear, that you can play around much without so much coding. I mean, you can play around much with the parameters and then without dealing much with Python, because this and the, as well this can be applied for any drone or the photo. Okay, so really thank you for following this tutorial. You will find all of these on the on a GitHub repository. And what else we can say about that? Please follow our YouTube channel. And then we are preparing a course on machine learning for crop recognition with Python soon. So, and then you will have exercises like this one developed by in a more explained way. Okay? So thank you for following us and have a good day. Don't forget to subscribe and to share. Bye bye. Bye.